All right, what up, YouTube? Welcome to the channel. I'm Shotgun Shogun. If you're new here, welcome, welcome. If you're not new here, well, welcome back. We've got some music, A World Reborn, from the music player in Epic 7. I've got some opinions, chat. I got some opinions today, and you know what? This isn't even necessarily just related to Epic 7. This is related to a lot of games. It's something I've seen a lot recently. And, you know, the nice thing about being a content creator on YouTube, Twitch, is that when I have opinions, guess what I get to do? I get to come online, I get to hit the go live button, and I get to talk about those opinions. And then you know what I get to do afterwards? I get to upload that video. And you, by clicking on this stream or this video, you have to listen to my opinions on this. Yeah, YouTube has a 70-30. That's right. Yeah, that's a whole other can of worms that I'll probably talk about at some point. Yeah. So you probably have deduced by now, if you're a smart individual, or maybe not even a smart individual, from the title of this video and the thumbnail, that my opinion is that developers of games should not listen to your opinions, or my opinions, for that matter. I don't think that anybody's opinion matters at all. I think that you, as an individual player, do not matter in the grand scheme of things when it comes to the opinions and the direction that a game goes. Now, a lot of people probably paused the video right there to go down to the comment section to tell me to, you know, to fuck off, that I'm stupid, that every game should absolutely listen to their player base. And I think that's true. I think that games should listen to their player base, but I don't think that that player base is the vocal minority. Now, because you clicked on this video, this is something I mentioned before I hit the record button, because you clicked on this video, you are in the minority of players for any game. If you are actively consuming media for the game that you're playing, you are in the 1%. Most players who are not hardcore, that's right, that makes you hardcore, chat. Everybody who clicked on this video, you are a hardcore gamer for whatever game it was that I tagged this as that you're looking for. Because I don't think that the casual player, the casual Andy, consumes media. They are not in Facebook groups. They're not on Twitter. They're not on Twitch.tv. They're not watching people stream the game on YouTube. They're not looking up really any information for the game. You know what they're doing? They're logging in and they're going, man, this character is pretty fucking sweet. I really like this character. This character looks pretty cool. I'm having a good time. I don't think that when it comes to Epic 7, that your average player gives a shit about RTA. I think that they don't care. That's why when all their focus is on RTA, I think that your average player just does not care. I think that a very small minority of a small minority cares about RTA. I think that an even smaller minority of that small minority that cares about RTA is worried about the game balance. And I think that the people who are worried about the game balance are typically bad at the game. They refuse to pull the meta. They refuse to build the meta. They refuse to go outside of their comfort zone, but yet they feel like they need to be legend. And you know who complains the most? Those people. Those people right there. And you know what? Their opinions? Worthless. Because you know what? It's a handful of people. It's the smallest minority of the smallest minority of vocal people that play this game. And when game devs cater to those people, they don't take into consideration all of the trickle-down effects that this has on everybody else. Take World of Warcraft, for example. When you build raids for the absolute most pinnacle mythic raider end game, no wifers that have been playing for 15 fucking years. Well, guess what? Your average dad that plays for 2 hours a fucking week is never going to get to see that. Why would you design game content for the lowest common denominator? Not only that, but have you guys ever seen the game community for the game that you play? Yes. And this can be a completely blanket statement because almost every game community is literal trash. Every game community thinks that they know how to balance and make a game absolutely perfect. If you're so fucking smart, where's your game? Where is your game? I mean, I'm shocked you're playing E7. You really never come back from even touching WoW. Career suicide. Yeah, tell that to Asmongold and Soda Poppin' and, you know, everybody else who has exponentially more viewers just literally going live playing World of Warcraft than the entirety of the Epic 7 community. Don't even act like you don't know who Asmongold is, Frost. But back to what I was saying, when your dev community caters to the minute fraction of vocal people that don't know what the fuck they're talking about, it ruins the overall experience for everybody. So I think game devs in general shouldn't listen to anybody. I think that they should make a game. And I think that they should have a design idea in mind. When the game starts to go into a path that people stop giving you money, like when it comes to like mobile games, then you can kind of rein it in. They have all the data in the background. I think anybody who thinks that they know how to balance a game, again, where's your game at? I think that it's stupid. I think that people who sit there and go, well, this should be balanced this way. Who are you? There was a thing about writing specifically that I remember. Writers write for themselves. The same really applies to all forms of art. I completely agree. Yeah, I completely agree. And I don't think that, honestly, I don't think that game devs should have to explain anything to fucking players. You're playing the game. If you don't want to play the game anymore and you don't like the direction that the game's going in, then fucking stop playing. But stop complaining that the game doesn't cater to you. I'm going to have a whole other video about people that complain about there being no content. That's going to be in a complete different fucking thing. Okay, New World is a different breed. They had people yelling at them and they didn't fix the seeable issues. How do you know that they weren't working on fixing that? Like, things don't get fixed in a day. It's the same thing with Epic 7. When they put something in that people don't like and they know that they need to fix it, they can't just fix it tomorrow. Like the pet snacks thing. They put it in and they went, oh, wow, okay, yeah, maybe this didn't work out the way we thought it would. They have data, you know, stuff like that. Am I saying that they shouldn't listen at least a little bit? Yeah, but I don't think that they should listen to everybody all the time about everything. Big, giant, sweeping changes? Yeah, maybe they roll those back, you know? But at the same time, the devs can put that out and be like, if they were adamant about it, they just go, you know what? It is what it is, man. You're fucking, you either play the game or you don't play the game. It does kind of get weird. How would you discuss something like League, which has gameplay and the world separated? Their gameplay is specifically designed around the player base for esports. I think the realm of esports does muddy this debate a bit. I disagree. Yeah, you put that shit in and people learn how to play around it. Like, what do you mean? Yeah, you just learn how to fucking play with it. Yeah, the problem with New World is they knew they had problems but didn't know how to fix them and or were not able to. Yeah, so I mean if they don't know how to fix it or they're not able to, it's not like they can just go, "Oh, well, fuck, you know, they should have, I mean, rolled it back," but like I also think New World had a whole lot of other issues and stuff like that. But I don't think that game devs, I think, so here, let me rephrase this. Game devs shouldn't listen to you. You specifically. You, the person who's watching this. If you becomes more than 51% of the player base, then they should listen to them, but not you. Yeah, you specifically, Londo. And you who's watching this video, because you don't know shit about shit when it comes to balancing a game. I also don't think the game should listen to like the upper echelon legend players. Do you think that Aether Bulge knows how to specifically balance a character so that it doesn't have sweeping ramifications over every other aspect of the game? PvE, PvP, whatever have you? No, I don't think that Smilegate knows how to do it either. No, they should obey and buff Ilyanov. Yeah, buff Cleave. Yeah. Aether Bulge is a genius, so he probably does. You know what? Then maybe he works in game development. I don't know. But I think that when people think that, I think game companies need to stop caving and catering to a vocal minority, because I think that a vocal minority doesn't have the best interest of the game in mind. I don't think that most players have the best interest of the game in mind. Most players have their best interest in mind. So when you have somebody who's like, yeah, players are selfish. Yeah, players exa 100% are fucking selfish. And so why would you listen to somebody who is, yeah, who is super selfish? I just want my waifus to be pickable in the meta. Yeah, sucks to suck. Yeah, get better, get different waifus. Yeah, that's the end of it, dude. And that's the problem as well, is that people want their units that they like to be pickable everywhere. And that's just not going to happen in any sort of competitive game. Yeah, it'll never happen in any sort of competitive game where, I mean, literally every competitive game has a meta. And you either play the meta and win, or you play off meta and have fun, and I put that in air quotes, and then complain about it. I want to first pick Araminta. You can. You're going to lose, most likely, but you can absolutely do it. The problem is that, again, game dev should never cater to the individual. Yo, big yikes, thanks for the follow, dude. I just think that it ruins games by catering to a vocal minority. Because the vast majority of your player base doesn't know that Reddit exists. And that's a good thing because Reddit and Stove suck. Yeah, they're terrible places. If people dupe stuff in New World, they should just fix it ASAP and not leave it so people could abuse it for a long time. Yeah, but how do you know that they knew how to fix it? Yeah, like, yeah, how, maybe they didn't know how to fix it. I mean, I think that they should always have a test realm and they should have people to be able to break it before it goes to retail. I mean, that's literally the easiest thing in any sort of IT field. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I could be satisfied with the meta and hope buff cycles in some new units to keep everything hype. Yeah, but here's the problem, right? You're literally stating everything I've been thinking since day one. The gaming minority consists of those who legit complain about balance and the like. Most players don't give a fuck. Yeah, most players don't care. Yeah, most players who play games just literally don't give two shits. Yeah, If I called like two of my friends that play Epic 7 casually, like right fucking now, they would not even be able to tell you who was meta. But yeah, at all. But here's the thing, Lord of the Sandwiches, is like now, if you have buff cycles that aren't game breaking, they're seen as boring. They're stale. The content sucks. But if it is game breaking, then it's too good. All of a sudden, people are complaining about the new meta cancer unit. I think that gaming communities were a mistake. I think that gaming communities are the absolute worst thing that can happen to games, honestly. Yeah, you can't please people. So why should a dev listen to anybody? Because you can never please everyone. So you have to just do what you can and fucking stick to it. I would have more fun in PvE without more units, I guess. I respect PvP, but the player base only views any changes through PvP lens. Yeah. Well, that's the thing. And if a PvE unit comes out, then it's boring. It's stale. This is the worst unit ever. Buff it so I can use it in PvP. Yeah. And that's another big problem, is that the devs, honestly, like, yeah, I think that they should just put stuff out, stick to their guns, and it is what it is. Yeah, I think most people are stupid. I think that most people who say that they know how to balance a game, they don't know shit about shit. They probably can't even hold like a full-time job. Yeah. Yeah, like what the fuck do you know about balancing a game, dude? Your status as a Shogun just make you wise, or are you just born this way? I was just born this way, I think. Yeah. What you're saying applies to MMOs too. Good God, things start getting less fun when they listen to the top 5%. Yeah, that's what I brought up. Yeah, I think that like you shouldn't cater everything to the absolute pinnacle mythic raider in World of Warcraft. One thing I really like, this is an obscure game. I don't know if you guys played it. It's called Rift. One of the things that I fucking loved about Rift, because I came back and I played it later, was they had like a solo single player mode for raids. Now you didn't get as good as shit, but you could go through and consume all of the content. You went through, you saw the story, you did some quests, you got some shit. You were able to do those raids without being the most epic echelon pinnacle raider. I thought that it was phenomenal. Yeah, I mean, yeah, games will never be balanced. And anybody who thinks that a game is balanced, that would be the most boring, stagnated fucking thing ever. Oh, every character is just literally the same, but just a different skin. Yeah, who cares? Yeah. Yeah, every game suffers from that. You have to make kits so far apart in what they do that there's no overlap when you try to get creative. Well, yeah, that too, because a lot of times if there's any overlap, they'll be like, oh, well, why wouldn't I just use this one? Yeah, and you get to avoid the worst part of MMOs, other players. That's true. I was in a group earlier, and I had like one of the worst healers, one of the bitchiest healers that I've ran into in a long time. Running in World of Warcraft. So yeah. Yeah, I agree with you 100% on this. I hate does not work in PvP stuff or PvE stuff. Like why? Yeah. Like that's the other thing too, is like when Smilegate builds something, like why not just make it work in PvE? Yeah. Who cares? Oh damn. Somebody finished Abyss with a gimmick character. Yeah. Who cares? Yeah. Who fucking cares, dude? Nobody. Yeah, no one was like, oh my god, this guy got an advantage in PvE. Yeah, whatever, man. An interesting thing is what Riot does with League of Legends. They have to figure out how to nerf some characters for top tier players while buffing them for the lowest tiers. They had a whole dev blog about it. I have to check that out. That would be kind of interesting. Only complaint I agree is that Smilegate doesn't do actual merch, and also, where is my anime? Well, yeah, but if they did actual merch, it cost you 4 times the amount to get the merch delivered to you. But yeah. When Shroon isn't God's Abyss unit because multiple don't work in PvE checks. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, but I think that, like, at the end of the day, to wrap all of this up, you know, this spicy take video that nobody got to at this point. Because I can't imagine some sort of, like, you know, shit post Andy is going to listen to 20 minutes of me talk about the same thing before making a dumbass YouTube comment about how wrong I am. By the way, if you did get to this point and you want to tell me how wrong my opinion is in the comment section, just know I don't care. Yeah, I literally don't care in the slightest. But I do appreciate you posting it about how wrong I am in the comment section. And, you know, thank you for the interaction. But yeah, I think that game devs need to stop catering to people. I think they do. I just put out a game. If it's a good game, people will play the game. If it's a bad game, people will not play the game. If the game is good, you should play it. If you're no longer having fun with the game and you think that the devs should change the game to cater to you, no, fuck off, dude. Go play something else. Yeah, literally any time that a game stops being fun, go play something else. Yeah. Honestly, I think that, like, one of the problems is that, like, with gacha games is that you are so time and financially invested that you are like, oh my God, this needs to change for me because I'm so invested. I can't play anything else. I think that's where a lot of it comes from as well. But just know that not everything's for you in a game, and the game doesn't have to cater to you. There's so many games that you could play. That's not this game. It is what it is. Yeah.